Old Richard had but one daughter, a maid of birth and fame. She loved her father's kitchen boy, the greater was her shame. But she could ne'er her true love see, nor with him could she talk. In towns where she was wont to go, nor fields where she could walk. But it fell once upon a day, her father being from home, she's called upon the kitchen boy to come and clean her room. Come sit ye down by me, Willie, come sit ye down by me. There's not a lord in all the north that I can love but thee. Let never the like be heard, lady, nor let it ever be. For if your father get word of this, hang me. Oh, ye shall ne'er be hanged, Willie, your blood shall ne'er be drawn. I'll lay my life in pledge of thine, your body's ne'er get rang. Excuse me now, my comely dame, no longer here I'll stay. You know my time is near expired, and now I must away. The master cook will on me call, and answered he must be. If I am found in bower with thee, great anger will there be. The master cook will on you call, but shall not answered be. I'll put you in a higher place than any cook's degree. I have a coffer full of gold, another of white money, and I will build a bonny ship and set my love to sea. Silk shall be your sailing clothes, gold yellow is your hair, as white as milk are your two hands, your body neat and fair. This lady with her fair speeches, she made the boy grow bold, and he began to kiss and clasp and on his lovely home. And she has built a bonny ship, set her love to the sea. 70 a brisk young men to bear him company. Then she's ta'en out a gay gold ring, to him she did it gee. This'll mind you on the lady, Willie, that's laid her love on thee. Then he's ta'en out a piece of gold, and he break it in two. All I have in the world, my dame, for love I give to you. Now he is to his bonny ship, and merrily ta'en to sea. The lady lay o'er the castle wall, the tear blinded her ee. They had not sailed upon the sea a week, but barely three, when came a prosperous gale of wind, on Spain's coast, land at ease. A lady lay o'er the castle wall, beholding dale and down, and she beheld the bonny ship come sailing to the town. Come here, my Mary's all, see ye not what I see? For here I see the bonniest ship that ever sailed the sea. In her there is the bravest squire that e'er my eyes did see. Oh, clad in silk and rich attire, and comely, comely is he. Busk and busk, my Mary's all, it's busk and make ye fine, and we will on to yon shore side invite yon squire to dine. Will you come up to my castle, to my table so fine, and you shall eat the good white bread and drink the claret wine? I thank you for your bread, lady, I thank you for your wine, I thank you for your kind offer, but now I have not time. I would give all my land, she says, your gay bride were I she, and then to live on a small portion, contented I would be. She's far away from me, lady, she's far away from me, that has my heart a-keeping fast, my love still she'll be. But ladies, they are unconstant when their loves go to sea, and she'll be wed ere ye go back. My love, pray stay with me. If she be wed ere I go back, and prove so false to me, I shall live single all my life, I'll ne'er wed one but she. Then she's ta'en out a gay gold ring, and gave him presently, 'twill mind you on the lady young man that laid her love on thee. The ring that's on my midfinger is dearer far to me, though yours were all the good red gold and mine the metal. He viewed them all, both neat and small, as they stood on the shore, then hoist the mainsail to the wind, adieu forevermore. He had not sailed upon the sea a week, but barely three, until there came a prosperous gale in Scotland landed he. Put paint upon his face and oil upon his hair, likewise a mask above his brow, which did disguise him sair. Earl Richard lay o'er the castle wall, beholding dale and down, and he beheld the bonny ship come a-sailing to the town. Come here, my daughter dear, ye see not what I see. Here I see the bonniest ship that ever sailed the sea. In her there is is the bravest squire that e'er my eyes did see. Oh, busk, oh, busk, my daughter dear, come here to me. Oh, busk, oh, busk, my daughter dear, oh, busk and make ye fine, and we will on to the shore side invite yon squire to dine. He's far away from me, father, he's far away from me, who has the keeping of my heart, and I'll wed none but he. Whoever has your heart in hand, yon lad's the match for thee, and he shall come to my castle this day and dine with me. Will you come up to my castle, to my table so fine, and you shall eat the good white bread and drink the claret wine. Yes, I'll come up to your castle, to your table so fine, for I would give my bonny ship were your fair daughter mine. I would give all my lands, he said, that your bride she would be, then to live on a small portion contented would I be. As they gaed up from yon sea strand and down the bowling green, he drew the mask out o'er his face for fear he should be seen. He's done him down from bower to bower, likewise from bower to hall, and there he saw that lady gay, the flower among them all. He's ta'en her in his arms twa, and held her courteously. Excuse me, sir, there's no strange man such freedom use with me. Her father turned him round about, a light laugh then gave he. Stay, I'll retire a little while, perhaps you may agree. Now Willie's ta'en a gay gold ring and gave her presently. Says, take you this, my lady fair, a love token from me. Oh, got ye it on the sea sailing, or got ye it on the strand, or got ye it on the coast of Spain, upon a dead man's hand? Fine silk it was his sailing clothes, gold yellow was his hair. It would have made a hale heart bleed to see him lying there. He was not dead as I passed by, but no remedy could be. He gave me this token to bear unto a fair lady, and by the marks he has described, I'm sure that you are she. So take this token of free will, for him you'll never see. In sorrow she tore her mantle, with care her hair she tore. Now since I've lost my own true love, I'll never love young men more. He drew the mask from off his face, the lady sweetly smiled. Away, away, you false Willie, how have you made me guile? kitchen he went through the hall, the wine glass in his hand. But little thought his kitchen boy was heir to all his land. But this she kept within her heart and never told to one, until 9 months they were expired, that her young son was born. She told it to her father dear. He said, "Daughter, well won. You've married for love, not for gold. Your joys will never be dark."